What is going on, everyone? My name is Shaq Mac, and today we got even more content. The Campus Legends content has been released. Man, we have been bombarded as of recently. We had the Prime Series one. We had the latest one, which was the Buzzer Beater St. Patrick's Day. We had the Spotlight Sim that came out. We had the Triple Threat Online cards that we're now getting. We got this now. So much new content. 2K, thank you. You're actually up to date with a lot of stuff now, and we really, really do appreciate it. At least I do. I certainly appreciate it. But look at all these new cards. A hell of a lot of new cards that we have to go through. Obviously, because there's so many, I'm not going to be able to do an in-depth one for every single one like I usually do with these overview videos. But I'm going to point out the ones that look most interesting and have the most interesting factors about them. And probably not going to go too far into them. Few of them like these two, Carmelo Anthony and Magic Johnson, I will be going a fair bit through. You guys will want to see what those ones are like. Obviously, this one is going to be probably a long one, but I do need to point out that tonight, as soon as this video comes out, as soon as you see this, I am live streaming. I'm going to be live streaming as long as I possibly can. That could be 2 hours. That could be 10. I honestly don't know because it could be late when this video is uploaded. You guys need to come down. I'm going to be doing my Spotlight Sim challenges. We're going to be having a lot of fun. Please come down and watch the video that I uploaded previously. I'm using those tips and tricks that I use in the live stream to complete my games. So I really hope you guys will come down. I really, really do hope that it is successful and it's a fun, exciting stream for you guys. And even if you don't come, just dropping a like on the video would be very much appreciated as well. One thing I do need to point out is that I have purchased some VC, nor do I have that much to open many packs with a pack opening this time. I do apologize. I really, really do. I have been busy with a bunch of things in real life. Haven't had much time to grind out some MT. And so unfortunately, it's only going to be 40k MT and 75k VC. Hopefully that still gives us a good pack opening though. It still gives us a chance. That's the main thing. It gives us a chance. I hope things go well, but let's look at these Campus Legends cards real quick. I'm going to go through a few that I think really stand out and have certain things behind it that could look really interesting. If you don't see it, it just means probably not worth it, in my opinion at least. So the first one that I'm going to show you guys is Dante DiVincenzo, which I think is how his name is pronounced. The thing I like about this card a lot is that it has a very big chance of being a budget bowler. 6'4", defensive overall is a 99. That's ridiculous for a Ruby card. He has an 85 offensive overall, which doesn't really matter because he has a 91 three-point shot, 84 driving layup, 90 mid-range, and an 80 close shot, an 86 ball handle, so he can speed boost, 95 steal, 95 perimeter defense. That is so good for a Ruby. This card is going to be so cheap. It's going to go for nothing, and he's going to play so well. Going to be very, very helpful. Going to cost, like, I'm pretty sure at the moment it did cost around 1k MT, so it's really nothing. A very good pickup for your budget baller squad. That'll quick, this is a 96 as well. And the badges, we're going to quickly go over here. Only 7 Hall of Fame badges, but a few like clamps and pickpocket to help out. Interceptor, really good defensive badges, and a catch and shoot. So hit him up with that 91 three-point shot and things will go well. That's really all I need to tell you about. He's got quick draw and range extender, which is in gold, which is very helpful too. Helps out his jump shot, but that's all I'm going to do for him. Now, the other one I'm going to point out is Eric Pascal. This card is 6'7", plays at the power forward, and has a 95 and 92 overall in both offensive and defensive. The reason I want to point him out is because Eric Pascal this year has gone under the radar, I think, a bit, purely because the Warriors haven't had a great season so far. But he does have an 88 three-point shot, so a serviceable three-point shot, as well as some good driving layup stats, and is quite strong down there. Works in the post too. Decent driving dunk. But he has an 86 ball handle, and that's kind of something I wanted to point out, because Eric Pascal did not come up to me as a ball handler. He really didn't. But to have an 86 ball handle, he can speed boost. This card is like a young Draymond. He is the Draymond Green, the cover of Draymond Green. He's got really decent defensive stats, not any DiVincenzo kind of things, but decent stats. He's got decent speed as well. So for someone who's 6'7", Avitus, and very under the radar, he has the chance to be a decent budget baller. I think he won't be as good as DiVincenzo, but he's definitely worth pointing out, I think. He has some decent badges too. He's got 17 in total. Got a lot of shooting badges here. He's got flexible release in Hall of Fame, which would be very helpful. Green Machine, Hot Zone, Hunter, pick and popper, difficult shots, catch and shoot. So I wouldn't take many off the jump shots with him. I would definitely drive towards the basket with him. He's got Hall of Fame Giant Slayer, which is very, very helpful. Pogo stick as well, so defense will be helped out in that way. But if we go down here, a few defensive ones in here. Clance is only gold, which I guess sucks. But he's a power forward, so I do not expect him to be playing too much perimeter defense, even though his perimeter defense is absolutely fine. But as you can go down further through here, has gold quick draw. So his jump shot isn't slow, but doesn't have range extender. So that's why I'm saying pick and popper is probably the most helpful, because I don't go too far out. They do usually come towards the three-point line and pretty close there. So you'll be able to knock them down pretty well. Jay Williams is another really good one, I think. He's going to go for a bit more, though, and I don't expect to see him too often. 99 offensive and only 94 defensive. As good as an offense can be, I do appreciate a better defense. Those help out a lot more. Jay Williams is only 6'2", which I say only 6'2", but the height needs to be a bit bigger than that for my liking. 95 mid-range, 94 three-point shot. So these shooting stats are actually really, really good. A 95 driving dunk, so he's a flashy dunker. A 92 ball handle. His defense is actually kind of decent. 93 steal, 88 perimeter defense. Could be a bit better, but he's very, very speedy, as you can see with that 98 speed, speed with ball and acceleration. He doesn't pop out too much to me, but again, go through the entire YouTube's opinion. Don't just come to me for opinions, because honestly, sometimes it really comes down to people who have experience with the card and who don't have experience with the card. Off my first looks of this card, doesn't look too great, but that's all good. He does have some really outstanding stats, so that could make him a lot better. But defense needs to be at least 98 for me to feel really comfortable about a card, and that's why I love DiVincenzo so much. Volume shooter, catch and shoot, floor general, difficult shots, so a lot of good shooting badges, obviously, with his 94. He's got Green Machine and Diamond with flexible release, Deadeye clamps. Thankfully, he has Hall of Fame clamps. I like a card with Hall of Fame clamps, at least giving me a bit of confidence. He has Giant Slayer, which helps for his height. Downhill, he's got quick first step as well, Showtime, so he is a very flashy player for sure. We go down here, he's got quick draw and range extender both in the gold, which is very, very helpful. He's got flashy passer too. Sure, why not? We can deal with that. But that's all I'm going to do for Jay Williams. Next one I'm going to bring up is Pink Diamond Christian Leitner. Now, a lot of people probably aren't thinking this one will be too good, but the thing I want to point out about this Christian Leitner, he is 6'11", and he has a 96 three-point shot. Depending on his jump shot, now I really do need to put this into perspective, his jump shot may be completely shit, but look at his post fade, post hook, and post moves, as well as that 3-point shot. Kick and popper, kick and roller. You do not bring this dude up with the ball, because if you go down here, ball handle's only a 69, and defense isn't as great as it really should be, if I'm being completely honest. But if you're looking for pure overpowered offense, and hopefully a good jump shot, this card will absolutely bring it for you. I really do have confidence in knowing this card could bring some really good things. He has Hall of Fame pick and popper. It is telling you to pick this card up for that reason. Drop stepper, post spin technician, put back boss. He is not one to bring the ball up, but he's one to catch and shoot, grab boards, put back up, or pass out. He is one of those players for sure. Hall of Fame quick draw and Hall of Fame range extender. I would not mind making a gameplay on this card, but honestly, I'm not too confident with cards like this. I've said it plenty of times before. I am more confident with cards that can play run and gun, and this card looks like it needs to really stop, take its time, and shoot, and I really don't have the patience for that, really. And that could just be my own fault, but I do not have the patience for that. He has Dream Shake too. A lot of post move badges. That's all I'm going to mention for him though. Let's get to the next one. Jimmer Fredette. Now, this one definitely in a lot of people's eyes is very, very, you know, exciting. A lot of people do like Jimmer Fredette from back in the day. 99 offensive overall, obviously, with a 99 three-point shot. He can dunk. He does some safe dunks, but obviously, Jimmer was known for his shooting. Not much. His playmaking. He has some decent ball handling, though. He got some so right defense. He's a decent defense. Not anything crazy, and he's pretty fast as well with lateral quickness at 95, but obviously, 92 defense overall gives me no real confidence in him, not as much as I'd like to have. So we're gonna go over to his badges. You could imagine that he has a lot of offensive shooting badges, catch and shoot, corner specialist, difficult shots, floor general, range extender, dimer, quick draw, of course, hot start, hot zone hunter, green machine, flexible release, deadeye, clutch shooter, all those good shooting badges that you really want. And obviously a lot of things to help him be a little bit of a playmaker too. But look, gold clamps, gold interceptor, not giving me too much hope. Gold pick dodger, gold pickpocket. He has them, but I'd like them to be Hall of Fame, and it doesn't give me too much hope for him. But if you're looking for an exciting player, Jimmer Fredette absolutely is one. Now, Ralph Sampson and Greg Oden. I'll show you Greg Oden in a sec as well, but they're both somewhat similar to me. I like Ralph Sampson a lot. He looks a lot better. Obviously, 7'4". He's a very tall player. 99 offensive and defensive overall, which is helpful. He has a 78 three-point shot, so he can't shoot at the center position, which is helpful. But honestly, this card, I feel like I'd like Z, Big Z, a lot better than Ralph Sampson. The only reason I say that is because he can shoot a lot better. And a card like this, well, even though his defense is very, very, very good, he doesn't look like a run and gun card. I like run and gun cards, and tall centers don't really fit my needs, because although he has 75 speed, it's not as fast as I'd like it to be. I usually run a lineup of Giannis, KD, and Dwayne Wade, and they can all burst up the court with no problems whatsoever. But if you're looking for a dominant card, this is absolutely one to look out for. You can see things like brick wall, pump fake maestro, pick and pop. He works really well in the pick and roll, pick and pop situation, but a lot of good defensive badges too, rebounding badges. I'm not going to go through reading all of them like I usually do, but a lot of really, really good ones here. And obviously, as we get to gold here, he's got gold quick drop, but I don't think I saw range extender. Am I wrong or am I right there? No, I did not see a range extender, which isn't too bad. He only has a 79 three-point shot, so I don't really stress too much about that. But we're going to go over to Greg Oden. I'm going to show you the similarities with this one. Both centers, both 99 offensive and defensive. This one's just a bit smaller, but Greg Oden, also a 79 three-point shot, also dominates in the post and off the pick and pop. Good dunking stats, less ball handle, but they're not supposed to have good ball handling at center. Defense about the same, rebounding probably the same. This Greg Oden's a bit faster, so that's a bit more helpful. I think I picked this one maybe over Ralph Sampson. Honestly, I'm still thinking about it in my head right now, but the cards are quite similar. Dream Shake, Pick and Popper, Pro Touch, Relentless Finisher, Post Spin Technician, Drop Stepper, Putback Boss. I don't know why I'm reading these again, man. Just a lot of good badges here. He has all of Van Clamps as well. Very, very, very helpful. Always love good defensive badges. Always love good defense. It's very, very helpful. And then as we go around here, he has a gold quick draw too, so his jump shot is not that bad. Again, both quite similar in their games. And finally, we've reached Galaxy Opal. Man, I feel like I've been reading for ages. You guys can't wait to reach the pack opening, can't you? But we're up to Magic Johnson. Super expensive. Let me get that out of the way. If I manage to pull a Galaxy Opal out of these, I'll be ecstatic. I really will. It'll be legitimately amazing. 99 on both ends. 99 driving layup. 99 close shot. 94 post fade. Post hook is 98. And post moves are 97. Draw fouls are 97. 3-point shots are 92, which is decent. Got some good dunking stats too. Ball handles, just man, passing is out of this world ridiculous. Defense is very good too. Rebounding is very good, as Magic was a very dominant pool point guard back in his day. 96 speed as well. This card has a lot of really good stats, not just potential. He is the best you can possibly get. 40 Hall of Fame badges. Hall of Fame quick draw. That's nuts. That's nuts, bro. So, as you can see here, bunch of amazing badges here. Everything. Just think of something. Think of a badge that you think is very important. He's probably got it. I'm not going to bother going through all of them. But as you can see, I don't think he's got Hall of Fame range extender, though, if I'm correct. I may have missed it. No. Hall of Fame range extender is not there. It's gold range extender, which is all right, I guess. I don't necessarily expect it. Dwayne Wade has gold range extender, and I'm still shooting from half court with that card. So, I'm not too stressed about that. This card looks like it could be very, very good, though. Looks like it's definitely very, very good. I don't know what I'm talking about, but let's go to Carmelo Anthony, because this one, I believe, is just a ridiculous three-point shot. I think it's 99 as well. No, I said 98, but still, point remains, very good shooter. He's got 99 on both ends, 97 driving lap, 98 post fade, 92 post hook. They both got very similar stats, except this one has better shooting stats, but I guess probably less. Yeah, he's got less passing stats. Ball handle's still a 97, but it's not a 98, 99, 99 like Magic. He's got not that good a block, but decent defensive stats in 91 steal, 92 perimeter defense, 90 interior defense. So he can contest all kinds of shots. Rebounding, not as good as Magic's, but 97 speed, 96 speed with ball, 97 acceleration. A very, very fast player. Very, very helpful. And finally, let's go to his badges. He has one less Hall of Fame badge than Magic Johnson, which is absolutely fine because they both go for a ton, and I wouldn't mind getting at least one of them. Carmelo Anthony, however, does have Hall of Fame range extender and quick draw. Very, very helpful there. And he's got a bunch. Just imagine all the good Hall of Fame badges that you can think of off the top of your head. He has got them. I'm just going to quickly go down the list here, just showing you guys this card is very, very good, obviously. But for obvious reasons, he's going to be very, very good. He's got a lot of defensive badges in the gold, which is absolutely fine, because I think this, if you want this card, it's going to be mainly for its offense. We are done with all the Campus Legends cards. Oh man, I didn't even go through all of them, and I felt like I went through a lot. Man, okay,
Let's get into the pack opening. You guys have been waiting for this.
Pack opening. You guys want this so bad, I can tell. I can tell you want it. I can really tell you want this damn pack opening. So, here we are. Not many packs we can open, unfortunately, like last time, but that could say some good, that could give us some good luck for this one. We used all our bad luck on the last pack opening. This pack opening is where it's gonna happen. Is where we're getting all the good stuff. I need a Galaxy Opal, man. I pray for a Galaxy Opal. We have 5 deluxe packs we can get with the VC. Hopefully we can pull something out of that. And if we can't pull anything out of that, I'll use my MT on these non-guaranteed packs, which hopefully we can get a bit lucky on them. Who knows? Who knows, we may be able to get a bit lucky on them. But let's stop talking. Let's open our pack. Come on. Karl Anthony Towns is on the front cover. These are guarantees that we can get anything from Ruby to Galaxy Opal. I'm going to close. I don't even want to. Oh, I'm out of here. I'm gone. Give me something good. If it's a Ruby, I'll kill you. I really will. I'll absolutely kill you. What is it? Ooh, a pink diamond to start off. Like I said, all our bad luck was in the last one. We're getting a pink diamond to start off, baby. Who's this one going to be? It's not Gemma Fredette, which is fine. It is a center. It's not Greg Oden. It is Christian Laettner. Now, I did say a gameplay on this wouldn't be too bad. And I think he's a decent pull. Definitely not my game style, but it'll be interesting to see how he plays and if I decide to do a gameplay on him. No guarantees. But that's a great start. A pink diamond in the first pack. Hopefully, that doesn't mean all our luck is gone. I'd appreciate it if it means that we still have a bit of luck because it was a 97. So we got a little bit of space, definitely a little bit of space. But next pack, I'm not gonna bitch it. I'm gonna watch the pack happen. I'm very happy with it, how that was going already. First pack, pink diamond. We will take it. They are guaranteed, so you kind of expect it. But nothing to the right. It's gonna be a Ruby. Okay, we were bound for a bad one. Dante, however, is a good card. Just doesn't go for much, which is unfortunate. You gotta expect bad packs. You really do. I'm not stressing, man. I'm feeling very good after that pink diamond pull. I'm feeling very, very good. We could have gotten a Ruby on that first one, and all that running away wouldn't have meant anything, and we'd be feeling bad. Obviously, it's not a big pack opening like they usually are. I mean, not a bad start. Can't complain. We're getting a Ruby, however. Jarrett Culver, the other one that we don't have, as well as the second play. Hey. I think I need to go away for the next pack again because that one, it's the only time we've gotten something good. Hopefully we get another good card in this runaway pack. That's what I'm calling it because I'm too scared to look at the pack. Come on, give me something good. Galaxy, Opal, gimme. Or at least a Ralph Sampson or a Greg Oden. You put me on a high with the first pack 2K. You gotta give me something good. This has to be a Galaxy Opal. I flipped it. Hopefully it's a Galaxy Opal. Hopefully it's a higher gem than it. Hopefully it's a pink diamond at least. I just want a pink diamond. 2K. It's a diamond. Okay, you know what? Diamond is alright. We don't have a diamond. That's absolutely fine. I feel like I need to keep running away from the damn thing every single time. I'm getting scared every single time. Who is this one again? It is Danny Manning, okay. I didn't look at his stats because he didn't look too exciting. That's all good. We're getting a diamond, getting more cards, adding to the collector level. Everything you can think of, we're getting here. We got one more pack with VC. Hopefully something good here again. But man, every time I look away, we get something good. I'm not sitting down in this chair. This chair is bad luck, all right? Chair is bad luck. Come on, one more pack with VC. Looking away again. I'm out of the whole screen again. 2K, if there is a chance for you to give me a Galaxy Opal here, I pray to the gods that you give me it. 2K, come on. You've been doing really well for us this week. Just, oh, please, I've opened it. Oh, come on. Something good. Another diamond, man. Really? All right. You know what? I can't complain. It's another diamond. Who is this one? Balls. This one is Jay Williams, the speedy little point guard. But we're getting a bunch of gems. And I really want to open the rest of my MT and packs. I really do. I'm going to... You know what? I can't bitch it, this one. I'm going to sit down and watch the next one. And then the last one will run away because that seems to work wonders for us. But man, pink diamond, 2 diamonds, no duplicates so far. I mean, we have gotten 2 rubies, but no duplicates. That's always good. We like no duplicates. This has actually been very, very good. I'm not going to lie. It's been very nice. But we're not running away from this one. No running away. We have got to knuckle down and take this like a champ. We're going to flip all. Bang. Like I said, it's just bad luck when I'm here, isn't it? We're getting a Ruby. Dante DiVincenzo. Man, okay. You know what? We're okay. Because this last pack is going to be a dub. Watch this. Last pack. Last pack is a Galaxy Opal. What can I say? What can I say? I'm just that good, aren't I?
I'm just good. Look at this. Last pack Galaxy Opal. What are you gonna do? I mean, I'm sorry, guys. I know you love a Galaxy Opal in your squad, but I'm gonna have to take one for my team. I just need one. I've opened the pack. I mean, sorry, guys. It's a Galaxy Opal. No. Fuck. I've gotten a ruby. It's just not good. Oh, God. All right. That's not funny, 2K. 2K, that is not funny. I am not okay with that. That is bullying. That is absolute bullying. We can't be having any of that.
You thought we were going to be done on that?
No, we cannot end on a ruby. I'm not allowing us to end on a ruby. But at the same time, I've only got enough for one more pack. So, 2K, how about we shake hands on this one? This one's going to be a dub, isn't it? Absolute. I saw something good and we got a damn amethyst. Okay, you know what? I wanted a Galaxy Opal really, really badly. I cannot lie. But we got Jahlil Okafor, another card that I didn't actually show anything about. Man, I would have really, really, really liked something good there to finish it off. But you know what? A decent pack opening nonetheless. Got a Pink Diamond Christian Laettner, so we can't complain too much. But man, I would have loved to have a Galaxy Opal. No, nothing wrong with how 2K has done me today, though. Much, much better than last time. Thank you very much, 2K. I very much appreciate that. So this is the locker code that we have been given for the packs today, and it is called Enjoy Your MT Weekend, which gives us a chance at a base pack, deluxe pack, or a regular standard pack, I believe. Hang on, no. It's got a base pack for Series 1. It's got a base pack. No, not a base pack. A deluxe pack for Series 1 and a deluxe pack for Series 2. So my guess is that everything is filled up with base packs and there's one spot for deluxe Series 1 and one spot for deluxe Series 2. Come on, tell me I'm wrong. Tell me I'm wrong too, okay? Go ahead. I can't wait for you to show me just everything that I didn't expect. Base pack is the ones on the, in the middle. Okay, you know. No, base pack's the one in the red. Okay, that's not bad at all. Take me to the right side and bang, we should be able to get something good out of this. Not bad, 2K. You have definitely surprised me. I will give you that for sure. Can't get any MT there, but that's absolutely fine. Show me something good. Don't give me the red. That's all I ask. That's all I ask, 2K. You give me the red and I swear. You give me the red and I swear. You give me the red and I swear. Good stuff. Good stuff, 2K. Beautiful. Thank you so much. This has been successful. This has been a successful video. I'm quite happy. We have gotten a Series 1 deluxe pack, which means we can't get anything over a amethyst, which I'm not too upset with because I believe they'll still go for a bit, especially right now. Maybe we can get a Hawks player. Hawks player is going for a bit right now because of the gameplay that I did last time for the Diamond Cam Reddish. That Diamond Cam Reddish is an absolute dub and is doing really well. We got a Silver. Silver's all right. We can live with a Silver. Dante Exum. That's all right. I think he'll go for a bit, so you know what? Not bad at all. Not bad. Anyways, if you guys did enjoy this video, please be sure to leave a like, comment down below any video ideas and suggestions, and subscribe to the channel if you are new. As I said before at the start of the video, definitely be sure to go and watch the live stream right after this. It'll be very much appreciated if you can join me. I really would appreciate all of it. Even if you don't do anything in there, just coming and showing a bit of support is absolutely appreciated. Thank you all so much for watching this video. I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye.